Hello everyone, I'm Howard. Today I'm going to talk about our research topic, the size distribution of particles in the ocean. And first we will talk about the base structure. What kind of particles do we collect? We collect size from 1 micrometer to 4,000 micrometers. And we compare two blank terms like blank gelatin. And vital grain protein like algae. And other minerals like dead bodies from food plants. And the reason why we want to do this research. Because the test scientists use means of screens and filters to try to measure the size of particles. But these studies and results are controversial. So we decide to use electronic determination because they greatly simplify the process of sizing particles. So finally, to find out the reason for variation of concentration in different areas. So we collect sample from Pacific and Atlantic Ocean in surface water and North Atlantic South Pacific Ocean in deep water. So first, we use easiest way to collect surface water. Just use buckets. We hang buckets behind our boat and our boat moves slowly so we collect surface water easily. And second, medicine bottles and medicine bottles are used to sample deep ocean. Benson bubble has a great way of messaging. And when the bubble reaches the required depth, the messenger is dropped down the cable. And when the wave reaches the bubble, the impact keeps the bubble upside down and traps the water sample inside. And this pink bottle is a direct development of medicine bottle. The bottle is a tube, and the modern pink bottle is remotely controlled to sample water by electrical signals. So we got a lot of results on the existing bottle and medicine bottles. So we will start with surface water of North Atlantic. And particle concentration of 20 north latitude to 40 latitudes are low. However, it has evidence of seasonal variation. As you see, samples in blue circles came from January. And samples in yellow circles came from November, and samples in blue circles have higher concentration than samples in yellow circles. And above 40 north latitude, the concentrations are greater, and below 20 north latitude, the concentrations are also greater. But it is because of island gas effect near West Indian Island here. So what is island gas effect? We have a lot of factors in island gas effect. First, like coral reef ecosystem projects. And second, animal waste products like human activities. And third, interaction of currents. Currents can upwell and mixing waters. And finally, island associated input like outflow from the rivers. So this better makes a lot of increased nutrients and total pollution in the surface water. So we will go down to the south Atlantic, between 25 south latitude to 50 south latitude. It is essentially a mirror image of the Atlantic, which means 25 south latitude to about 35 south latitude, the concentration was low. And between 40 south latitude to 50 south latitude, the concentration became low. And below 50 south latitude, the concentration are high. And large particle forms greatest part of materials. So next we will go right to the South Pacific. Its distribution is similar to the South Atlantic. It says the concentration are lower. And there is one thing special to mention. High concentration are found near the Chilean coast is due to the effect of harmful currents. So finally, we have the equatorial and North Pacific Oceans. And between 5 south latitude to 24 latitude, the concentrations are higher than subtropical area. And in subtropical area, the concentrations are familiar to the same area in North Atlantic. And above 40 north latitude, high concentration are found with large particles like light pumps in many samples. And so we separate two oceans into four types. A type was polar. And higher concentration in size can be found here, like algae and flagellates. And B type is temperate type. Higher concentration in every size here. And C type is subtropical type. It has lowest concentration among these four types. And B type is equatorial type. High concentration in size of 20 microliters. Next, we will talk about the relationship between depth and size distribution of particles. As you can see, figure A came from 5 stations in the North Atlantic. And figure B came from 3 stations in the South Pacific. And figure C is a combination of figure A and figure B. And in this A station, we can find that the deeper ocean deep is the greater concentration of particles are. And finally, we found a lot of reasons that make variation in concentration. Seasonal variations, island mass effect, currents, and numbers of large particles affect in surface water. Biological effect and sedimentation affect in deep ocean. And that is my present here. Thank you.
All right, so 7 seconds less. Okay. Okay. Steven. Who's up? Zhang Zhiying. Edwin. Aries. Aries. Does it read Aries? Okay, starting from Steven.
I see the left 26. How did you divide those areas? You use the data or
No,
those ABC.
Yeah, we use the similar data in each area.
Shows all the show me the graph of the North Atlantic.
Would you like to explain why they are the what caused the seasonal difference in North Atlantic, both North and South?
Repeat this question.
Why there is this kind of relation between North Atlantic? And because we only put seasonal variation in Greece, and we only want the same growth. I think it is because the sun light, the time the sun light the ice in ocean, and we can see a variation in numbers of ocean. So
you mean sunshine?
So there is no variation between June and
August. We have to stop here. I know that there could be more questions. Okay, Aries.
Your professor showed that the higher density bar is the bigger particles are. And can you explain the simple way why it happened?
Can you repeat this question? So you see that you have actually very little introduction slides. So my overall question would be, why should we care about particles? Why? So I think, you don't have to answer me right now, but I think you need to add that in your next talk. At the very beginning, why should we care about particles in the ocean? Okay. What's the importance of this question? Okay. And then, okay. So now here you talk about some, this is a little bit about a deeper research background. So you say that you say previous people, previously used screens or filters, etc. And controversial, maybe some of the audience doesn't know what's controversial. What's controversial? You have to explain. Argument, okay. Then you have to explain. Then you say now you decide to use electronic determination. However, in your material method, you did not explain at all what's electronic determination. What's that? You have to explain. Yeah. I think that's related to the modern particle size analysis. And then now you come to your study area. However, that's related to my another major comment. Your figures are always very small. If I were you, I would probably make this figure this large. Like this. At least. And furthermore, when you paste the figure from the paper to the PPT, you do not need this. This means figure caption. You can actually remove it. Then this will make your figure a little bit bigger. Bigger figures are always welcome, always. So your figures are always small, too small. Okay. I don't know what's that. And then you talk about Nason, but here that's probably a typo. You have Nansen or Nason, I don't know. Okay, here, look at your figure again. This little figure. Small figure. I can't even read it. And another major comment is, I think between this slide and this slide, you should spend one slide introducing this. Because that's in the paper. Here they explain this figure. This one. Right? Yeah, you have to tell the audience because later on you show many these types of figures in the map. But you did not explain at all what's the x-axis and y-axis. Okay, so that this is a particle size distribution plot. You need to explain that. So that means between this and this, spend one slide on that. Then here you have many distribution plots and you can go up. And then, of course, I need to mention that in this slide, this is too small, and then you have to introduce figures, the figures. How to do that? What is x-axis? What is y-axis? What are the points? And that's related to the Kuzo's question, okay? So you need to introduce the figure first before go on with your interpretation. How do you pronounce this? All right, now it sounds right. But it didn't sound right during your talk. Yes. Okay, the last thing is you have many data. Therefore, it's especially crucial that you always use your pointer wisely. Right? Because you didn't use your pointer very often. Yeah, I know. So you need to practice. Make it better next time. But overall, the the talk is improvable, and the good thing of your talk is you always add this concluding sentence next to your figure. I think you also find it helpful because you know what to say, right? You always have this. Okay. Good. So now let's think.